Hey everyone, Charly here. Today we'll export a hairstyle from ZBrush. I created a basic hairstyle for this tutorial, skipping details, to demonstrate how to transfer any hairstyle created in ZBrush to 3ds Max using a file in 3ds Max. There'll also be tutorials for Maya and Cinema 4D on the channel. There are two main methods to export a hairstyle. The first is export curves, meaning exporting curves. To preserve the entire hairstyle, set PreVis to 100% in preview settings. For curves with further work in Ornatrix, I recommend setting 10 to 25%. We'll cover both methods, starting with 100%, to get an identical hairstyle without tweaks in 3ds Max. We'll also explore the 25% method and a third option, exporting polygons. Exporting polygons is suitable for working with strips or converting to HairFromMeshStrips. Here's how it works. Let's start with curves at PreVis 100%. Click Export Curves and confirm. This will export 6,536 curves. Save to a convenient location. Open 3ds Max, go to File, Import, Import, select the Curves file and click Open. Ensure Shapelines is enabled or the curves won't import. Other settings aren't needed. Polygons are unnecessary since these are curves. Click Import. You'll get an identical hairstyle with the same number of curves. You'll need a scalp or the character model. I'm importing both the model and scalp. Now the curves are ready. Combine them into one object. Pick Fiber 1. Click Attach, Multiply, and add the rest. 3ds Max will take a moment to process. It might take longer for you. You end up with Fiber 1, curves ready for conversion into Ornatrix guides. Before converting, check the points. Yellow points should be at the scalp's base. If none are visible, everything's fine. The curves are ready. Now let's convert to Ornatrix. What's required? First, hide the model, keeping the scalp. On the scalp, use Tools, ResetXForm. Do the same for the curves, ResetXForm. Select the curves, enable Effect Pivot Only. Press Shift-A, select the scalp, and use Align to World for proper pivot alignment. Everything's now set up. Great. Select the object and add Ornatrix Ox. Add hair or use the preset. Choose Guides from Curves. We get the needed curves. Hide fiber, as it's no longer needed. We end up with Guides from Curves and Ground Strands, where we load the scalp. I'll name it Scalp. Disable Ground, Closest End, click None, select the scalp and click Select. In Guides from Curves, enable Normalize Coordinates and set 15 points. For smoothing, we can add detail later. Click Ox Edit Guides.
For better performance, set Guides Width to 1. This boosts performance, but for selecting guides, increase Guides Width to see selections clearly. This affects visibility.
Now we have Edit Guides, ready to convert into hair. We want to preserve the hairstyle shape. My hairstyle isn't final, but if yours is, you can stop here and render. I'm demonstrating the method. What's next? Add OxHairFromGuides to generate hair. Enable the guides as hair option. This creates hair with the same shape. Add ChangeWidth to match the ZBrush form. The shape holds up during rendering. If I render now, I'll see the same shape. The result is identical here. You can use Ox Multiplier to increase density or add edit guides.
For example, if the hair looks sparse, I'll change the object's color. Enable Object Color.
Now we see all the hair created from these curves. To improve the visuals, I recommend enabling high quality. This makes the result clearer. But always verify on render, as 3ds Max Viewport is inferior to Maya, and Ornatrix GPU is limited here. Viewport gives a rough preview. If there are bald spots, they can be fixed. Reminder, this is a quick example for me. Yours might be final. Let's assume this is a final hairstyle from ZBrush. Then you can add clumping, like random clump, set to 100 clumps. Also add frizz, using length dependent, adjust amount, and scale. Set amount, for example, to 5. Outliers to 10, and increase the percentage. I often do it this way. It's a quick setup method. If you don't want to tie fibers to the scene,
Use Collapse 2 on Ox Edit Guides to remove fibers and avoid slowing down the scene. Now you can render, hide the scalp, show the character, and set up lighting.
In the next episode, we'll continue.